What's up, everyone? Welcome back to the shop. You are building a box and you want some of those sweet miter joints. And when you do it, you see that the grain wraps around beautifully from one side over to the front to the other side, and you get to that fourth corner and the grain doesn't line up. So how is it that you can get the grain to go all the way around the box? Let me show you. I got a piece of walnut here, and I picked this on purpose because it has this beautiful sapwood plus the heartwood, so we can really see that grain flow. Now we want to build this to be 9 by 6. Well, let me take my ruler here and I'm going to place a mark at 9. That's one long side. And I'm going to place a mark at 6. And then we are going to add the thickness of our table saw blade. In my case, it's 1/8 of an inch. So I'm going to cut it there, which means I need a board that is exactly that. One long side, one short side, the width of my table saw blade. Now that I have a game plan, I can take it to the table saw and cut it to length. Now that we cut this in length, we need to rip it in half. Now I'm gonna do it at the bandsaw because I want as thin of a curve as possible. I'm gonna mark the center of my board using a combination square. For my own sanity, I'm also gonna draw a triangle on here. This is just gonna help me to line everything up later. You can see our triangle, and if we open it up, you have this beautiful book match look. Now, at this point, there's still some saw marks that I need to remove. You can run those through the planer or the drum sander, but just go deep enough to remove the saw marks. Don't go any deeper. The deeper you go, then the less likely your grain's gonna match up. So if your boards are not the thickness that you want, remove the material from the outside, not the inside. Again, we have our triangle, and if we were to set them like this, you see we have the book match look. But instead, we're gonna put them end to end. If we put them end to end, we see the grain wraps all the way down. We could also move this down this way and put this end together, and it does the same thing. Really cool. So now we get to lay this out and figure out where we wanna cut our boards at. Well, if I take my ruler here and I say, let's do 9 inches, so I'll make this the long board. And then this will be the short board. And then this one will be the long board again. And then this will be the short board. So what I know is I have to cut this right here, and that will give me my 4 pieces. Time to cut some miters. I like to use the table saw, but you could use a miter saw or router table, whatever works for you. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna set my blade at 45 degrees and I'm gonna make a cut. And I'm gonna be kind of far off, and I'm gonna sneak up on it and keep cutting until my blade just kisses that outside edge. This is our outside face. To make sure I don't screw up, I always like to take my boards, flip them over, and place marks where I want those miters to be at, because I will accidentally mess up and I will cut this one to match this one, and then the grain won't match, obviously. We got all our pieces, so let's tape it together, see what it looks like. Let's look at our grain. Beautiful how it swoops down through that joint, comes up, comes back down. That could be a beautiful box. That's how you get your grain to wrap all the way around the box. Now, if you're wondering, how do you get those miters so tight like that? Well, I've got videos on it, so maybe check that out or one of these other videos that you might enjoy. Until we meet again, get in your shop and build something awesome.